initially when we used to prepare mini projects for syllables and all, we used to take out easy topics because we used to feel that no, this is too difficult for us. But in EYSC specifically this year, we took a challenging task. We were like, no, we're not gonna pick up easy tasks, we're gonna use challenging tasks. So, and we are able to implement it successfully. Though there were difficulties, we were able to overcome it. I used to be very underconfident, and I used to have an imposter syndrome, like, I don't deserve this, I'm not capable of doing this. But now I feel that, okay, this is challenging, I can do it. Even though I don't know anything, but with my research skills, I can solve this problem. And also, I'm able to take in charge, you know, I can manage a project from scratch.
Before EYIC projects, I can say that I was kind of scared to go through research papers, to do anything which was not given before, right? Like, it is already done before. It's very easy to create a touchless doorbell, right? But these people have helped me to develop the habit of taking risks, that we can do it with research. The main habit of research was the one that they have all taught me.
I was not a very talkative person in front of someone. I was like, okay, I will be scared or something. But now I can talk to someone.
Teaching in the classroom, the particular subject of the semester is not enough actually. So we have to reach out to the student, we have to see what is their interest, and accordingly we have to give them the direction. In your college, a student and a faculty member is ready to work something, the institute should have to give the 100% support to them. So that just looking at a one single group, the another group come up for doing such a things, or another faculty will join to this thing.
When they created the fusion module, we printed the fusion module, and after that I was working, like me and Iram were working on the software side. So we had decided we'll put Raspberry Pi, we'll put Arduino. But after when we met and we were like, okay, now we have to implement the sensors on the robot, right? We became difficult for us to space it out. Then we had to remove the Arduino, we had to implement everything on the Raspberry Pi. So we could have discussed all this earlier, and time would have not been wasted that much. If you are implementing something like totally on the software side, I'll say it'll be like, we should do it stepwise. If you are, for example, if you're telling you want to implement a sensor, right? You have to integrate 5 sensors together in a robot. So you should first test each sensor alone in the in a good condition, a working condition. Are they working properly? Are they giving us the results? And then start integrating them one by one. If you do all the things together, it will be a mess and you will not know what is going wrong and where it is wrong. We had integrated all our sensors on Arduino, and in the end, when we started implementing it, it was showing that the memory is less, so you can't actually use the Arduino. So we needed a bigger Arduino for that, and we can't fit that bigger Arduino in the bot, because the bot is size of the bot is small, limited. So we had to shift all that. So these are the things that you actually come to know. Like, you can't think that these errors will come when you are planning it, but these, you learn them when you actually do the project. And that's why you should actually complete a project, the implementation of a project.
Initially I used to hate debugging. I used to write program, and if I face any problem, I used to give it to another team member to solve it. But this time, because we were having such shortage of time, I did debugging on my own. Initially, I used to look on forums like Stack Overflow or Unix.com, help the problem. If that didn't help, I used to read documentation and all. And even if that didn't help, I used to go for an alternative method. So for every code or every function, I had an alternative function. If this didn't help, this will help us. So that helped me. And one more thing which I learned is always keep a backup code which will execute if your main code doesn't run. It helped me change my vision towards the debugging. So now I kind of enjoy debugging tools because it helps me learn another ways to solve the problem. If they want to be called an engineer, they should participate in eYantra according to me. Because the technical skills which you learn in eYantra are, that those are mind blowing. You can't get those skills in 4 years of engineering which you can get in 1 year of eYantra project.
Basic idea behind joining a competition is it's a kind of spirit. That the spirit of a competition teaches the students the importance of the taking a healthy risk. instead of doing activities which they normally do in their comfortable zone. Yeah, I always behave like that. They never feel like that I am a one faculty. They should have a feeling like that I am the fifth member of their, so that they will come to me for their each and every small problem. Otherwise, if we keep the relation like that with the student, ki I'm a faculty and why you can't do this and that, this will not going to help. If my student is just ready for doing something new, solve some problems which the society is facing, definitely I will be there with them for all the time. This is my promise. So we are going to make such a network. Last year students participated in eYantra. Now they have continued their work. Even though in this pandemic they used to come in the college, so these students, they got a lot of help to get some direction as they have worked previously on such live projects. So it helped them, these students also. So this is a kind of environment we are trying to create in the institute. Their seniors are going to be guide them for many things. I am going to use my time for the making new set of students for the next year.